So up till now we talked about two methods of asexual reproduction. We discussed fission, the three types of fission, that is irregular, longitudinal and transverse, and then we talked about budding, two types of buddings, exogenous and endogenous. So in this chapter of reproduction in organisms, let us take up other methods of asexual reproduction. The next method that we are going to discuss is, this is the third one, it is fragmentation. We will discuss two things simultaneously here, fragmentation and regeneration. Fragmentation, as the name tells us, that the parent body divides or breaks up into fragments or pieces, and each piece gives rise to a new organism. Fragmentation is normally seen in filamentous alga, for example Spirogyra. So there is a long filament. This filament breaks into parts. It can break accidentally or due to constrictions or dissolving of the wall. This is having cell wall. So suppose from here the wall dissolves, and from here also the wall dissolves. So we will get 1, 2, and 3 fragments, and each fragment will now give rise to a new organism. So basically parent body splits or breaks up into fragments or pieces. Regeneration is also pretty much similar, but regeneration term is normally used in case of animals. For example, here, okay, so in example of fragmentation, let us write Spirogyra. Whereas in case of regeneration, we talk of animals like Planaria. Now the interesting thing about Planaria is that it can show binary fission also, and it can show regeneration also. So in case of Planaria, its body, it shows constriction from the middle. The body starts to stretch. The anterior end fixes at one point and the body starts to stretch, or the posterior end will get fixed at one point and the anterior end will start getting moving forward. So it stretches. As a result, we start seeing a constriction. So here a constriction appears, and this complete organism breaks up into two parts. Each part gives rise to one organism. Now here it is undergoing splitting to produce two, and that is similar to binary fission. But there is a power of regeneration which is present in lower organisms, like in case of sponges also, in Planaria also. If this planarium is cut into various parts, each part is capable of regenerating into a complete organism. So that is the basic small difference between fragmentation and regeneration. The next method of asexual reproduction is by spore formation. Various types of spores are formed. If the spores are motile and have flagella, then they are known as zoospores. Zoospores we have seen in lower plants like algae, Chlamydomonas, Spirogyra, Eulothrix. So here we can write examples of Chlamydomonas, Eulothrix, Spirogyra. In all these, motile, flagellate spores are formed. Now these spores, they can be, they are
drop like, they can be biflagellate
as we see in case of Chlamydomonas,
and they can be quadriflagellate, 1, 2, 3, 4, like we see in case of Eulothrix,
but they would have flagella. Such kind of spores are known as zoospores, the motile spores with flagella.
In fungi, the spores are either called basidiospores, like in case of mushrooms. In case of rhizopus, let us take fungi. In a fungus, that is rhizopus, that is bread mold, the structures, that sporangiophore is produced. At the tip of it, there is a swollen bulb-like structure which is known as sporangium, and it produces the spores, which are known as sporangiospores. So here they are circular non-motile spores, but individually they are released from the sporangium. If you take the example of penicillium, in case of penicillium, these spores are produced in a chain. So in penicillium, from the hyphae arise these small structures, which are again sporangiophores, and they produce these spores which are in a chain. Such spores are known as conidia. So in penicillium, conidia are formed. These structures are called conidia, and these will be detached from the tip. So new ones would be added from the bottom, and the completely formed spores will be released from the top. These conidia have reserve food material, so they contain sufficient food. In some fungi, they don't have reserve food material. Then those structures are known as oidia. So they are same, but they don't contain enough reserve material. Conidia can withstand adverse conditions, oidia cannot. Oidia, they cannot. Reason, they don't have that much of reserve food material. So spore formation, which is a characteristic feature of lower plants like algae and most of the fungi, because fungi are reproduced by spore formation. Now let us take the next method of asexual reproduction, which is called vegetative propagation. In vegetative propagation, some vegetative structure, that is stem, root or leaf, any of these structures help in propagation or reproduction. Vegetative reproduction has been reported in plants naturally. There are many plants which reproduce by this method naturally, but we will talk about some artificial methods also by which we can get the same type of plant, but it is artificial method. So let us talk about the natural methods first.